Yeah. Now, second sum we will solve. X square minus 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. So, now solution. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So, what is a? A equal to 1, b equal to minus 3, c equal to minus 2. Right? Now, if you want separately, you can find out b square minus 4ac. That will be easy for you. B square minus 3 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 2. So, 9 plus 8. So, 17. Okay. Now, what is the formula? Minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Right? So, minus minus 3, very careful, na? Sign and all. Plus or minus square root of 17 upon 2 into 1, which is equal to 3 plus or minus square root of 17 upon 2. So, x equal to 3 plus root 17 upon 2 or x equal to 3 minus root 17 upon 2. Therefore, 3 plus root 17 upon 2, comma, 3 minus root 17 by 2 are the roots of quadratic equation. That's all. Okay? Now, next sum. Similar one. Third sum. Quickly we will solve all the sums. Now, third sum. 3m square plus 2m minus 7 is equal to 0. So, solution. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, we get a equal to 3, b equal to 2, c equal to minus 7. So, we will find out first of all b square minus 4ac. So, 2 square minus 4 into 3 into minus 7 is equal to 4 plus 88. Now, formula. What is x? Minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So, substitution should be very perfect. Plus or minus root of 88 upon 6. So, again equal to, we'll write plus or minus. How can you write root of 88? 4 into 22 upon 2. So, it is equal to minus 2 plus or minus. What is square root of 4? 2 upon 2. So, that is equal to, see what is common? 2 common. Minus 1 plus or minus square root of root 22 upon 2. 2 get cancelled. So, you will get minus 1 plus or minus root 22. So, what you will get? X equal to minus 1 plus root 22 or x equal to minus 1 minus root 22. Therefore, minus 1 plus root 22 and minus 1 minus root 22 are the roots of the given quadratic equation. How simple this? Three we have left out. Okay. So three. Now next sum we will do it. What is the next sum? You can try next sum. I will do it the fifth one. Y square plus 1/3 y equal to 2. So you have to write in the standard form. Y square plus 1/3 y minus 2 equal to 0. So comparing ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, a equal to 1, b equal to 1/3, c equal to minus 2. Therefore, b square minus 4ac, first of all, you will find out 1/3 the whole square minus 4 into 1 into minus 2. So 1/9 plus 8. So what you are getting? 73/9. Now x equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a is equal to minus 1/3 plus or minus square root of 73/9 upon 2 into 1. So minus 1/3 plus or minus 73. So we don't have any factor upon, what is the square root of 9? 3. Right? Upon 2. So we will take here, this is 3 minus 1 plus root 73 into 2. So we get minus 1 plus or minus square root of 73 upon 6. So what is the answer? X equal to minus 1 plus root of 73 upon 6, or x equal to minus 1 minus square root of 73 upon 6. Therefore, minus 1 plus 73 square root and minus 1 minus square root of 73 upon 6 are the roots of the given quadratic equation. Followed? This is very simple. Now what we will do is, one more sum is there, that also we will complete it. Okay, six sum, 5x square plus 13x plus 8 is equal to 0, solution. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, therefore, what is a? 5. What is B? 13. What is C? 8. So we will find out b square minus 4ac equal to 13 square minus 4 into 5 into 8, 1, 2 into 5. 169 minus 160 upon 10. So 9 upon 10. Sorry. We wanted to find out only b square minus 4ac only. Okay, sorry. Now, what is the answer? X equal to plus or minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So, minus 13 plus or minus. What you got? Nine. Now what I will do? I think one step I have used it. Okay. Now x equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a means minus 13 plus or minus square root of 9 upon 2 into 5. So equal to minus 13 plus or minus, what is the square root of 9? 3. 10. So x equal to minus 13 plus 3 upon 10, or x equal to minus 13 minus 3 upon 10. So what you will get? X equal to minus 10 upon 10, or x equal to minus 16 upon 10. Therefore, x equal to minus 1, or x equal to minus 8 upon 5. Therefore, we write minus 1 and minus 8 pi upon, or the roots of the given quadratic equation. Now, what we'll do is, see, listen very carefully. Any equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, this is a quadratic equation. So you are always having two values of x. That means you are having two roots. Okay. Now, for example, is the quadratic equation. You have got two roots which we do not know. We call it as, let alpha and beta are the two roots. Means what? What is the value of x? Alpha. And what is another value of x? Beta. Because this has got two roots. One root we call it as alpha, another root we call it as beta. Now you take this side, x minus alpha equal to 0, and take this side, x minus beta equal to 0. Now see what I am doing. X minus alpha, x minus beta equal to 0 means what? Either this equal to 0 or this equal to 0. So now if you simplify, what will get? X into x minus beta minus alpha into x minus beta equal to 0. So x square minus x beta minus alpha x plus alpha beta equal to 0. So here x square, what is common? Minus is common, x is common, alpha plus alpha beta equal to 0. So now listen very carefully. This is what? See, what is alpha? One root. What is beta? Another root. So we are adding sum of the roots. Here what we have done? Multiplied. So product of the roots. Product of the roots. Now you see. That means x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta equal to 0. I am writing like this. So x square minus sum of roots into x plus product of roots equal to 0. So if you are given two roots, then you can find out the quadratic equation. That is what we are going to do is, okay? Now listen very carefully. Activity, page number 48. Activity. What is the quadratic equation? See the question. What is the quadratic equation having roots alpha equal to 2 and beta equal to 5? It is a reverse process. Okay. So far what we have done? We are given the quadratic equation, we try to find out the roots. Now roots are given, we have to find out the quadratic equation the other way. So what is the formula? X square minus sum of the roots in x plus product of roots equal to 0. That means x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta equal to 0. So x square minus, what is alpha? 2. What is beta? 5. Plus 2 into 5 equal to 0. So x square minus 7x plus 10 is equal to 0. See how simple is this? So if you are given the roots, then you can find out the quadratic equation. Okay. One more sum we will do it now. Now listen very carefully. See, now x equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. This is the formula through which you can find out the value of the roots of any quadratic equation by using formula method. Now here b square minus 4ac, we found the values, no? This is called discriminant. And denoted by delta. So one symbol is there, b square minus 4ac. This is nothing. So if you are asked to find out the discriminant of the quadratic equation, what you have to do? You have to find out a, b, c from the quadratic equation by comparing with the standard quadratic equation. Then you substitute the value of b, a, c here, you will get it. Okay, now
when some people do.
Fine. Problem, practice 2.5. Second sum. Find the value of the discriminant of first sum x square plus 7x plus 1 is equal to 0. So comparing with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Therefore, a equal to 1, b equal to 7, c equal to 1. So now we have to find out the discriminant. What is discriminant? B square minus 4ac, which is equal to, what is b? 7 square minus 4 into 1 into 1. 49 minus 4, sorry. It is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, plus, so it is 53. Any doubt? Is it difficult? No, it is very simple. Now, in this also second one, 2y square minus 5y plus 10 equal to 0. So, same way, comparing with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Therefore, a equal to 2, b equal to minus 5, c equal to 10. Therefore, discriminant equal to b square minus 4ac, which is equal to minus 5 square minus 4 into 2 into 10. So, 25 minus 80. So, minus 55. Got it? Now, next one. It's very simple. Only thing, you have to find out properly the value of A, B, C and substitute. Right? Now, 3. Root 2 x square plus 4x plus 2 root 2 equal to 0. Solution. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, what is a? Carefully you should write. B 4, c 2 root 2. So, what is the discriminant? B square minus 4ac. What is b? 4. 4 square minus 4 into root 2 into 2 into root 2. C 4 square is 16 minus 4 into, this will write 2 into root 2 into root 2. 4 to the 8. Root 2 into root 2, 2. So, what is the value of this discriminant? 0. Okay. Now, see for rules. If delta equal to 0, then roots are real and equal. If delta is greater than 0, then roots are real and unequal. If delta is greater than 0, then roots are not real. Means what? If the value of delta is equal to 0, then both the roots are equal. If the value of b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, then roots are real and unequal. Otherwise, what happen? They are not real. They are imaginary. Now, we will see one by one. Determine the nature of the roots. Okay, first sum. X square minus 4x plus 4 is equal to 0. What we'll do? Same thing. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, a equal to 1, b equal to 4, c equal to 4. Okay. Now, what do you have to find out? Delta equal to b square minus 4ac is equal to 4 square minus 4 into 1 into 4. So, 16 minus 16 equal to 0. As per rule, what is that? The roots are therefore roots are real and equal. That much you should write. If it is greater than 0, real and unequal. Another sum. Second one. 2y square minus 7y plus 2 is equal to 0. Same thing, comparing ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, a equal to 2, b equal to minus 7, c equal to 2. So, del equal to b square minus 4ac is equal to minus 7 square minus 4 into 2 into 2. So, 49 minus 16. So, 33. So, here delta is greater than 0. 33 is greater than 0. Therefore, roots are real and unequal. So, third sum also will complete it. M square plus 2m plus 9 equal to 0. So, comparing ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Therefore, a equal to 1, b equal to 2, c equal to 9. So, we have to find out discriminant is equal to 2 square minus 4 into 1 into 9. So, 4 minus 36 minus 32. So, what happened here? See, minus 32 in a number line, it is less than 0. Therefore, roots are not real. Understood? Please note down or take a snapshot. Right?